Four
days until the most important election of our lifetimes. And you don't have to wait for November 3rd to cast your ballot.
Hi everyone, welcome to Katie Mack Comments, a channel where I, Katie Mack, comment. But in all seriousness, here on my channel, we discuss social justice issues, pop culture, and feminism, all from the lens of my gender studies and psychology degrees. So if any of that interests you, be sure to click the subscribe button down below. Today, we're going to be talking about voting, as everyone who can should be exercising their right to vote in this upcoming election on November 3rd. I will be going over how to vote early, how to research candidates, how to fill out your ballot, how to turn in your ballot, and I will share resources to help you find state-specific voting information. By the time this video goes up, it'll be too late to vote by mail in most states, so I'll be going over absentee ballot drop-offs and in-person voting. Check your eligibility and voter registration. So first, you need to check if you're qualified to vote and whether or not you're registered. The nationwide list of criteria to qualify to vote includes being a U.S. citizen, aged 18 or older by election day, November 3rd, 2020, being registered to vote in your state, and meeting your state's residency requirements. If you are not yet registered, but your state allows you to register up to election day, head to register to vote in the description down below. Making a voting plan. Once you have ensured that you are both eligible to vote and registered, the next course of action is making your voting plan. Determine how you will be voting, when you will be voting, and where your polling place or ballot drop box location is. To decide how you will be voting, check to see whether or not you received an absentee ballot in the mail. If you have received an absentee ballot, you can fill that out and take it directly to a ballot drop box or election office near you. If you have not received an absentee ballot and are going to vote in person, check to see if your state offers early in-person voting so you can avoid lines and large groups of people. If your state offers early in-person voting and you decide that that's what's right for you, go to find early voting locations in the description below to find out where you can vote in your area. If you prefer or need to vote on election day, head to locate your polling place in the description below to ensure that you're headed to the correct location. If your polling place is different than what it has been in the past, don't stress. Election officials are attempting to move in-person voting to larger buildings so that social distancing guidelines can still be followed. If you're nervous about going to the right location, you can check your polling place at multiple websites linked in the description to ensure you go to the right place. Make sure to check your state's laws on voter ID requirements to guarantee that you bring the necessary materials to vote. Make sure safety is a part of your voting plan. As Chris Clements highlighted in one of his most recent videos, safety should be a top priority of your voting plan. Chris illustrated that safety while voting is not only about social distancing, although that is massively important. Voter safety also involves being prepared for attempted voter intimidation and having a plan for dealing with potential verbal assault. Ways to prepare for these things include having voting buddies to stand in line with, carrying pepper spray for peace of mind, and knowing your rights. Voter intimidation is defined by the United States government as an attempt to prevent eligible people from voting or forcing them to vote a certain way. The attempt may be made by an official, individual, or group. And some examples of voter intimidation include verbal or physical threats, threatening with weapons, or uncertified or illegal poll watching. Knowing how to handle an instance of voter intimidation will make you more prepared to vote safely and without fear. Voter intimidation is a form of voter suppression, and it's a crime because you have the legal right to vote and vote freely. Voter intimidation is surging during this election, so it's more important than ever to make sure you're prepared. Poll workers and security are aware of the increases in voter intimidation and are there to help you. If you feel intimidated or unsafe at any time, make sure to reach out to a poll worker or security personnel. Although voter intimidation attempts are surging, know that the poll workers are there to help you, and the most important thing you can do to stop it is prepare for it to happen. Voting should not be scary, and you should be able to exercise your right to vote without fear of harassment or retaliation. In addition to preparing in case of voter intimidation, make sure you wear a mask and try to keep distance of at least 6 feet from others at all times. If you must vote in person but have the option to do so early, that may also help you more easily social distance. Be ready to stand in line for a while. Bring water and snacks and anything else you might need for waiting for extended periods of time. Research the candidates on your ballot. To easily find what's on your ballot, simply click on one or both of the links under Research Candidates on My Ballot in the description and enter your home address. From there, they will calculate your specific ballot and you will be able to easily see a list of all the candidates and proposals that you will be voting on. These websites were designed to make voting as easy as possible for you, so you should be able to find all the information you need right on these pages. However, for some local candidates, it might be hard to find more in-depth information, so Googling their name and the position they're running for should help you find their campaign website, which should contain more about their policies and goals. Back on the voting research websites, you can go through your ballot and select who you want to vote for, and you can then either email that list to yourself or print it out to bring with you to the polls. Never before has it been so easy to be a well-informed voter. Although going through all the candidates' responses to each issue may be time-consuming, ensuring that you are voting for people who represent your best interests is extremely important. Taking the extra time to vote from an informed point of view is well worth it, especially considering how urgent many of these issues are coming to be. On vote411.org, you can even watch videos of all the debates for the various races you will be voting on from the same page as your ballot overview. These websites are streamlining the researching process for your ballot and will help you ensure that you are a well-informed voter. Don't underestimate the importance of voting for local and state officials in addition to voting for the president. Making sure that you're well-informed on all the candidates will help you in shaping your city, state, and country into the place you want to live. Don't forget that positions such as judges, attorney generals, and prosecutors show up on the ballot in some states and can influence the criminal justice system in your area greatly. How to fill out your ballot. According to a study by NPR, more than 550,000 ballots were rejected in this year's primaries, and another study shows that young first-time voters and people of color have more ballots rejected than other groups. In my opinion, this is yet another form of voter suppression because they make ballots difficult to understand and harder to fill out than necessary. A study found that the top reason absentee ballots were rejected in the 2016 election included having a non-matching signature, returning the ballot past the deadline, or having no signature at all. Make sure that you read the instructions very carefully, as you don't want your ballot to be thrown out for a silly mistake. In some states, election offices have been throwing out absentee ballots that are not in the provided secrecy envelope. So make sure to follow the exact directions so your vote will be counted. If you're dropping off an absentee ballot at a drop box, you will want to make sure that you enclose it in the envelope that was provided with your ballot and the secrecy envelope if that is also included, as this is how the election office can certify that your ballot is legitimate. You should also make sure that your signature on your ballot or envelope matches your signature on your driver's license or other state-issued ID, because they will be comparing your signature to the one that they have on file for you. Other common issues with absentee ballots include using the wrong ink color, marking the ballot outside of the bubbles, tearing the ballot, or returning an illegible ballot. We must make sure to follow the rules strictly so we can ensure that every vote gets counted. Dropping off your absentee ballot. If you're voting using an absentee ballot, make sure to bring your ballot to an official drop box or, if you can, drop it off right at your election office. I personally decided to drop my ballot off at my local election office, so I knew that it would be there in time to get counted. Most states also offer ways to check to see if your ballot has been received, and you can also check on election day to see if it's been counted. To see if your state allows ballot tracking and to track your ballot if it does, go to track your ballot in the description below. Working at the polls. If you want to get more involved, consider working at the polls. Because of the virus, poll workers are needed now more than ever. And if you feel comfortable and safe doing so, I'm sure your help running polling places would be greatly appreciated. If you want to contribute further to ensuring our democracy can thrive, being a poll worker is perfect for you. To find out more about what being a poll worker entails, check out workelections.com. While the amount of rules surrounding how to properly vote can be quite daunting, remember that your vote matters and it's worth the extra effort to make sure that it's counted. This election is the most important election that I've been alive for, and I want to ensure that my voice is being heard. If you have friends who could benefit from this video, be sure to share it with them and spread voter education far and wide before November 3rd. That's it for this video, but before I go, I want to remind you to check out the links in the description below for places to donate, sign petitions, and learn about the Black Lives Matter movement and how to vote. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you've made it this far, comment "please vote" down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!